say it, but nothing recorded for the first couple minutes of that.
It's all right. Do you have it now?
Yeah, we have it now, but for like the first probably many minutes it wasn't recorded.
We got 10 minutes till school's over!
We own a restaurant that serves pints of duck sauce. Yes, our pints come in squeeze bottles. So, our family, we're not Irish Catholic though. We have this weird tradition that we do every December around the holidays. What we do is we take a Christmas tree, wrap an American flag around it, and put it in a room with a cap. Then, we light a menorah and stick it at the base of the Christmas tree to decide what religion we are. See, we light everything on fire and then decide what religion we are. So, if the Christmas tree survives, then granted, you know, we're Christians for the year. You know, if the American flag burns, then of course, we're radical extremist Islamics for the year. You know, except for Ramadan, because, you know, our family isn't quite down with that whole fasting concept. Now, the menorah usually survives, but it all depends on the year, you know. Some years it's in to be Jewish, some years it isn't. They're very trendy people, the Jewish. So, now, the cow usually dies of smoke inhalation. But if it manages to survive, then it's a hell of a feat. And we consider it holy, so we're Hindu for the year. If everything in the room burns, which usually happens, we have to make a choice. You know, if we're feeling all spiritual and religious like this year in the wake of September 11th,
you know, then we'll be Buddhist and respect all religions. But if we're feeling lazy, realize that none of the gods have really stepped forward to convince us of their various religions, then we say screw it and feast on the burgers and steaks from the dead cow for the rest of the evening. So you guys can tell I'm a pretty smart guy, you know. I like talking trash, but I'm not so good at sports. So what I gotta do is I gotta say, I gotta talk trash for my strengths, which are my academics. So I'd be like, what's up? Yo, that's a pretty nice poster. I bet your mama's up all night making that for you. Or I'd be like, I'll school you on that multiple access conjugate reciprocal factoring test. I bet your favorite problem-solving strategies, guess and check, boo. So now, all you guys, all you girls out there, freshman guys, freshman girls, you guys in health class, have you guys had that lady talk to you about sexual harassment yet? You know how sexual harassment has a zero tolerance policy? How no means no, and there's no such thing as girls playing hard to get? Well, it occurred to me, and I asked the lady, then Pepe Le Pew, the skunk from Looney Tunes. He's a repeat sexual offender then. See, you guys know, he's always chasing that same girl, and that girl's just teasing him. And his best excuse is, ha-ha, you know, the girls, they like to play hard to get, no? Listen to this actual quote from Pepe Le Pew. Listen carefully. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Catch a lover by the toe. If she holler, hold her closer. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo, so. What the hell are they teaching our children? Do you realize what that basically said? That just said, if a lover hollers and resists, repress her by holding her tightly. And the studio, all they did was, they just made it, they gussied it up and made it sound all cute with that whole little eeny, meeny, rhymy stuff. But the message of sexual harassment is still loud, clear, and perverted. Another thing, the girl, Penelope, it's just a cat with a white strip of paint. So the writers of the show think it's okay to write about interspecies, unwelcome sexual advances. You know, they should really lock up that dastardly skunk. No, no, officer, you do not understand. She was playing hard to get, no? Thanks, everyone. Have a great night. You guys were awesome.
September 11th was an event that affected us all, both as individuals and as a nation.
We found it important tonight to pay tribute to those who lost their lives or those who lost friends and family.
We also think we should pay tribute to America's bravery and its strength. Now we'd like a moment of silence before we move into the next act.
Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear. Already come.
Thank you. I'm trying to find out what's the new line. Thank you for coming to the show.